Hi, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in this video, I'm going to talk about event delegation in JavaScript. So event delegation is an important topic whenever you are working with DOM, and if you are doing DOM manipulation in a next level, so you will each and every time you will get this concept. This is known as event delegation, right? So before start the topic, I need some setup, right? So that particular setup is this. I have this particular page, HTML page, with along with I have some of the CSS, so styling this particular div, right? And I'm not using any kind of external CSS libraries like your Bootstrap, right? I'm not using that. I'm just using the simple one. Now I need one more file, that is my app.js. And in the app.js, I will just do one alert and say, yeah, JS is connected, right? JS is connected. And if I reload it, okay, it's nothing happened because this JS is not connected. I will write here app.js. And if I now run it, yeah, JS is connected, right? Now I will remove this particular code, and what I like to show is that these two buttons are working, is functional, right? So to make this two button functional, what I need document.querySelector, and I need to select the ID of the class, right? So in that case, I don't have any ID, right? So I will write here one class. Okay, so that class will be my btn. Let's say it's btn submit. Okay, btn sub sub. Okay, that will be fine. Now it's btn serve, and this one is btn. So I will write query selector, and for the first button it's btn, right? This class is btn, so I will write dot btn, and I will write dot add event listener. And here I will plus, there are too many event listener events in JavaScript, but I'm actually more focused on click, right? So I will pass this arrow function. If you can see this one, just let me little bit do these things. Yeah, now what we will do, I will alert, I don't alert this time, I will do a console log over here. And yeah, this comma, right? There is a red indicator that says I missed one comma. And now I will, in the console, I will print clicked, btn1 clicked, right? btn1 clicked. Now for the if now I reload this one and just go to the inspect, and in the console I can see whenever I will click, just give me some time. Yeah, if I click the first button, it says button btn clicked, right? I should mention the btn1 over here. Yeah, btn1 clicked. If I just again reload it now, yeah, you can see btn1 clicked, right? In the console it's printed that btn1 is clicked, right? Now I have to do this thing for the next button as well. I will just straight away copy it and change this btn to sub, and it will be btn sub. Okay, and it will be my button to click, right? Now if I just go back to my application, I reload it. If I just click on this, oh, maybe I have done some mistake over here. document.querySelector.btnSub, this should not. Okay, if I just reload again, if I click on this, why these two buttons are getting clicked at the same time? I don't know. If I click on this, something is happening. But if I click on this, it says two buttons are get clicked. But oh, okay, that is the problem, guys. I was mentioned to give this particular dot, it was comma, right? So it's my bad. So for that it was happening. So if I now click on this, it says BT on one click. If I just click this one, oh, again it's a problem. This one is fine. If I click on this one, oh, it's nothing happening. BTN sub sub sub, it's still, it's not, it's type it's submit. That's why the page is getting reloaded. Maybe if I just reload it, this page actually gets reloaded when I'm clicking on the submit. Oh. Okay, this is happening because this button is inside this particular form, right? So as it is inside this form, and whenever we submit the form, the page gets reloaded, right? So if we want to get read out of it, what I need to do, I need to pass here one particular thing, that is event, right? And what this event will do, it will prevent, right? So it will write event dot prevent default, right? Now I think it, the form will not get reload. So now if I just reload it, submit it, you can see this button 2 is clicked, right? So that's the problem was happening previously, that it was getting reloaded and it was the form was getting submitted, right? So that was that. That's why the page was getting reloaded at that time. Now, okay. So I don't need this prevent default for the time being. So what I need is very simple. On the click on this button one, button one, I like to display this particular text, right? So first, I need to clear this particular HTML. Okay. So for that, what I need to do, I need to just go to this particular section. So you can see inside this div, inside this class, div class, this entire HTML is there, right? So करना क्या है मेरे को? इतना ही है कि इसको clear करना है. So I will just go back over here, and yeah, I will write document. Document, sorry, document. Sorry. Document dot query selector. Query selector, and inside this query selector, I will just copy this one, this class name. And once I copy it, I will paste it, and I will just write inner HTML and in the backtracks, and just save it. And now, if I click on this particular button, what will happen is that entire div will be empty, right? So if I clicked, oh, it says inner HTML of none, null extra says btn, right? Btn sub. I think this is happening because of written in even listener. I click here again. This issue is says inner HTML of null and the HTML. Oh, btn dot on this click. I like to clear this particular text, right? And if I, for the time being, if I comment this out, this code, I think now it should work, right? If I click here. Again, it says text area HTML. Okay, yeah, so I'm coming to this point later. I just go back to my HTML page. So here is my class, here is my class dot text area. Oh, sorry, this is happening because of I forget to give one particular dot over here. And if I if now I'm save it. I'm just going back, and if I click here, see the HTML, entire HTML is vanished, right? Now, now I'm not going to comment this particular code out. Comment out this. Sorry, I'm not going to comment out this particular code. I will just remove all the comments from here. And now, if I just save it, it will not give me an error. But what I need to do, again, I'm going to reload it. So I need, what I need to do, if I click on here, this div will be clear as well as this particular form will be visible at that particular div one, right? So this is my div one, this is my div two. So I like to show this div two inside this div one. So for that, I will just go back here, and I will just first I will just copy it, copy this particular text, and I will paste it. And then what I will do is I will just going back to my HTML, and I will just copy this particular div, right? At that time, if I save and reload it, see my div is not there, right? And now I will just go back to my HTML, and I will paste the entire code here. Okay, and Here is the formatting for, here is my formatting for a better understanding of code. And if I just now reload it, here you can see, if I click on this button, see, I have this form. Now if I click on the submit, what will happen? It's again getting reloaded, but trust me, if I want to show this thing console log, right? So I'm not doing console log over here. I like to alert something, right? I like to alert, let's say button to click, right? BTN to click. But see here also it will won't work because the event delegation, it says event listener of null, and that is the problem you can solve using event delegation, right? What's happening over here is whenever you are in the page, right? This is whenever you are loading the HTML page, what happened is there is no information in the HTML. See, here is no information about your the next formation, right? So here you can see this is the thing is there, right? If I click here, see, these two divs are newly created, right? Now, if you want to catch those div using the JavaScript, JavaScript has no idea, or your DOM has no idea that these two HTML has created, right? But it has the idea. It's directly no, saying that it has no idea is really wrong. It has the idea. But again, it can't work on the button or the event which was not there at the start, very beginning of your HTML page, right? So in the very beginning, let's say in the very beginning, there is no button named submit. So as it was not there, you can't give a event listener on this particular button, right? But you can do that using the event delegation part. So in event delegation, what happened is you need to go for a parent class, ठीक है? मतलब इतना ही है कि आपका जो आपके HTML पेज में जो बटन पहले से क्रिएटेड नहीं था, जो आपने जावास्क्रिप्ट से तैयार किया, उसके ऊपर आप अगर इवेंट लिसनर डायरेक्टली लगाएंगे तो वो काम नहीं करेगा, ठीक है? तो फॉर दैट आपके पास जो ऑप्शन है वो है कि यू कैन गो फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर कंसेप्ट कॉल इवेंट डेलीगेशन, राइट? सो यूजिंग द इवेंट डेलीगेशन यू कैन सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम, ओके? नाउ या एंड हाउ यू विल सॉल्व दैट प्रॉब्लम इन इवेंट डेलीगेशन, यूजिंग इवेंट डेलीगेशन, इट्स अगेन वेरी सिंपल. दैट इज यू विल जस्ट गो फॉर योर यू विल जस्ट लुक फॉर द पैरेंट क्लास विच वॉज प्रीवियसली देयर, एंड उसी पैरेंट क्लास को पकड़ के आप अपना काम कर लोगे, ठीक है? सो यहाँ पे आपका पैरेंट क्लास कौन सा है? आपका पैरेंट क्लास है ये, ठीक है? दिस इज द पैरेंट क्लास. आपको इसको पकड़ के आपको पूरा का पूरा काम करना है, और ये कोड आपका नहीं चलेगा, ठीक है? सो आई विल स्टार्ट विद डॉक्यूमेंट सिलेक्टर, एंड हियर आई विल पास दिस पर्टिकुलर पैरेंट क्लास. यू कैन सी दिस इज माई पैरेंट क्लास, राइट? दिस डिव वॉज प्रीवियसली देयर, राइट? So I will just go here and I will write dot add event listener, and inside this I will write on the click, right? On the click what I want is I want to see that if there is some click in the event. So I like to see, I like to check, right? So here I will pass one particular thing. This is known as E, right? This is the event, right? And you can say let target, and after that you can check if target dot class list, if I am not wrong, class list target dot class list dot contents. यहाँ पे थोड़ा सा ट्रिकी होता है. क्लास लिस्ट डॉट contains, and inside this you need to pass this particular submit button ka class, right? And inside the bracket you need to pass, you need to say, yeah, alert it was clicked. It was clicked. Say it will be button to clicked, right? It will be button to clicked. Okay, now if I just reload it, clicked here. Oh, maybe I have done some mistake. Target Okay, it was Stargirl. It will be target, right? It will be target. It will be target. Okay, now if I reload it, just go here, click here. Oh. Okay, again, I have done one mistake. That will be this particular add target over here. I missed one dot, right? Now, if I just control C over here, just go back and yeah, if I reload it, and now if I click over here and we click, yes, see, so we are finally done. If I click on this book button, I can see this particular form. And now, if I click on the submit, yes, this button too is clicked. So this entire concept is known as your event delegation. And if you are working with the DOM manipulation, you will be counter with this topic, right? So thank you, thanks for watching, and please hit the subscribe button if you are new to this channel.